Well, thank you all. On behalf of the family, thank you all for being here today. We're here to celebrate the life of Miss Ione Cunningham. And she's one who was dearly loved, obviously, in this community and by this family. And her life was a blessing to so many. It's in times like this that we all need to hear words of comfort and reassurance. And the best words of comfort and reassurance are words of truth. And the best words of truth that I know are those that come from God's holy word. I have a few scripture readings from Isaiah and from Psalms and from John. From Isaiah 40. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is an everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. From Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yes, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod, thy staff, they comfort. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And these words from the Gospel of John. Jesus said, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I'm going. I will not leave you orphaned. I'm coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. I've said these things to you while I'm still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you everything. And he will remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not let them be afraid. The love of a mother is indeed the most special love that we can experience in this life. A love as powerful as a mother's love for her children leaves its own indelible mark on every one of us. We all have a mom, and Miss Ione was indeed a special mom to so many. The neat thing about a mother's love is that a mom's hug lasts long after she's let go. And those memories that she built with you and you built with her over those many, many years, and those many hugs, I doubt you could count all the hugs that you've gotten. But you still remember the love that came with them. A mom's hug lasts long after she's gone and long after she lets go. And so it's the treasure of the memories of the love that you share, that you still share. Death ends a life, but it does not end that relationship. She's as much your mom and friend today as she's ever been and always will be. A beautiful poet said this, wherever a beautiful soul has been, there is a trail of beautiful memories. And that is indeed so with Miss Ione and the memories that you have with her and the life that she shared and the love that she gave you. The cakes that she baked, the memories that she shared. You'll treasure those all of your days. And when you think of her, she'll still be hugging you. And she'll do that until you breathe your last. And when we all die and when we all get to heaven, we'll be greeted by the greatest hug of all. A hug from Jesus, a hug from God, and a hug from all those who've gone before us. This is not goodbye forever. This is we'll see you in a little while. Thank you.
Listen, if you will, to words of comfort and assurance and perhaps even challenge that come from the very heart of God. The psalmist said, I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. Brought me up out of a horrible pit, out of miry clay, set my feet upon a rock, and established my goings. In the words of the prophet, when thou passest through the waters, I'll be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. Death's not ever a welcome event, regardless of how it comes, its timeliness or lack thereof. It's never a welcome event. And if we focus on that, then that can challenge our faith and that can challenge our sanity. If we give in to it imposing itself on us, it leads us to despair, leads us to discouragement. Miss Ione was known by a lot of different names over the years. Mother, grandmother, aunt, sister, she was always just Miss Ione to me. It took me a long time to learn how to pronounce it. I used to say it just for the fun of it in ways that I knew she didn't appreciate. And without a doubt, that woman could hold a straight face longer than anybody I knew. When you would do something foolish and she would start her straight face look, she could hold it longer than any of us could before we would break and giggle and smile and go on with the next joke or whatever the next opportunity was. She asked me one day, she said, I understand your wife likes Elvis. I said, well, I do too. She said, I didn't ask you that. I understand your wife likes it. I said, yes, she does. Do you? She said, yes. I said, well, you probably remember before he came along, don't you? And she said, that's not any of your business. How appropriate to have Elvis sing today. I say all that to say, our focus shouldn't be on the fact Miss Island's gone. That brings us to despair and discouragement. Our focus ought to be on the fact Miss Ione was here. She was in our midst. She was among us.
Mama.
Think about all the things that you as a family and we as friends, think about all the things that we did together, the good times that we shared. And think about the difficult times that we endured together. And remember everything that she meant to you. And then think about the span of her life and all that was accomplished in that life. And the example that she was by her own life. Recall her commitment to her family. Her commitment that carried over from family to her friends. And remember that each of us are better today because we walked in the shadow of Miss Ione. We don't need to focus on the fact that she's gone. We need to concentrate diligently on the fact that she was here. The Bible says, for as in Adam all die, even so in Christ we shall all be made alive. Death's inevitable. Our being here today is another testimony of that. The Bible says death's inescapable. It's no respect of persons. And that's a negative thought. That causes despair and discouragement. Let me remind you of a greater fact. Our God's omnipotent. Our God's all-powerful. He's more powerful than this thing we call death. And He's ever-present. And He's always near to encourage. For He cares for us even in and especially during our times of sorrow. So from the fact that death's inevitable and the greater fact that God's omnipotent comes a challenge. And that challenge is that you and I be dependent. That we depend upon God as our creator and our sustainer and our redeemer. That we depend upon Him by resigning our strength to God's power and rest in His promises. For it was Him who said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. It was Him who said, come unto me all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. So I encourage you to exercise a definite and a deliberate faith in God and in the fact that He loves you. To exercise a definite and a deliberate faith in Christ and what He accomplished at Calvary to help take some of the sting out of today. And to exercise a definite and a deliberate faith in the Spirit of God who's able to comfort you and give you peace. Paul to the Ephesian church said very simply, be strong. He didn't put the period back. He didn't leave us to figure out where strength would come from. He said, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. We trust God today and depend on Him to get us through these moments and then those difficult moments, days that lie ahead. But we do so not focusing on the fact that Miss Ione's gone, focusing on the fact that Miss Ione's and she made a difference. Kipling says it like this. When Earth's last picture's painted and the tubes have twisted and dried, when the oldest colors have faded and the youngest critic has died, we'll rest in faith, we'll need it, lie down for an eon or two, till the master of all good workmen shall set us to work anew. And those that were good shall be happy, they'll sit in a golden chair, they'll splash at a 10-league canvas with brushes of comets. They'll find real saints to draw from, Magdalene, Peter, Paul. They'll work for an age of the city and never grow tired at all. And only the Master shall praise us. And only the Master shall blame. And no one shall work for money and no one shall work for fame. But each for the joy of working and each in her separate stall shall draw the thing as she sees it for the God of things as they are.
should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadows come? Why should my heart be lonely and long for him? Jesus is my portion, my constant friend is he, for his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Your heart be troubled. His tender word I hear, and resting on his goodness, I lose my doubt and fear. When Jesus is my portion, my constant friend is he, for his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me.
Let us pray. O God, all that you've given us is yours. As first you gave our own to us, now we give her to you. Receive her into the arms of your mercy. Raise her up with all your people. Receive us also and raise us into a new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. And into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Ael. Acknowledge, we beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeemer. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, into the glorious company of the saints of life. And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen.